Welcome to etherlords 2, I'm your host Lostwolfe. When last I left you, we had travelled over the bridge over here to have a look around. And we'd run into this rat guy. And we had a problem with the rat because the rat had rat's tenacity. So he got really big and I got sort of screwed. I'll try it again with the same deck, but if it doesn't work out, then, you know, that's just that. I'm going to edit this away. If it doesn't work, we'll try a different deck. Or we'll try a different build of a deck. So I shall see you, hopefully, just before I win. This is being edited out. I shall see you shortly. Okay, I'm midway through this match, and I believe I've won. Essentially, what it boiled down to was just being very, very patient, removing all of his enchantments, and then going to town on him. He has no cards that he can draw. He's got one right in play. I'm hoping to eventually find a removal spell, but I think I'm going to win here. So, there we go. I figured it was okay, I just made a mistake last go around. Right, we get weakened. Weakened is terrible, and I don't really care. Power and toughness of the enchanted creature are reduced by 4, but toughness cannot become less than 1. If the spell has been discarded by an opponent's hero, the opponent discards 3 spells. Yay! Okay, that takes care of the rat. The rat that was guarding all this other funky stuff that I wanted. Welcome to the episode proper. Hooray! Grabbing. What is it, this? Oh. Interesting. Okay. That's good, because it will be like we had it last go around. Hopefully. Oh, okay. Good. So, our rat's haste, first strike, and discard 1. One rat has returned to the game, but we haven't been playing rats in a long time though, so I don't know what's up with that. Hello.
Be careful, warrior. The enemy is everywhere.
Yeah, don't need to tell me. I am discovering simply by being here. Oh, hello. Look at this mess. That's a tunnel. I wonder where that's gonna move me. It looks like, oh, it's not. It's gonna say it looks like the common resource, but it isn't the common resource. What is, I think I'm I know we've been here before. This looks like the city. It does, doesn't it? And then I'm gonna go this way real quickly. Just to satisfy my curiosity. But I want to say that this is where we came in. Oh, hello. Yeah, because that's the lightning generator, which is where we got this. Okay, so we have definitely been this way before. Huh. I wonder why it would point us here. Oh well, the only thing for it is to keep exploring. I guess, although we have already been along this bridge. Yeah, we have, because this will take us back to. Yeah. Ah, meme person. There.
Where's my sister now?
I don't know. And if I knew, that would solve a whole bunch of problems. You know what? Hang on. Didn't I just casually ignore the teleporter? I want to say I did, but then you come here and you look at this and I can't get out of here. So there are people I can fight there. There's a dude right there who is a Cyclops. Wow, he's level 12? I don't quite know how I'm supposed to get there though. More importantly, I don't know why I should be fighting level 12. He looks like he's over here. So I am gonna run. That way real quick, like, hey, how did I not collect that? I walked around here and everything. Like, I made a point of walking all the way around there. Okay, so this guy was that way. He was that way. I don't think I can get there from here, can I? No, I cannot, actually. I can get there. I want to say that I can get there from the bridge here. This is a bridge. And I don't think I've been here before. No, I have not. There we go. Problem solved. Hello there. Spirit level 6. Free casting. Oh, goodness. The hero has a chance to cast a spell without paying its ether cost. Response variable, casting cost, initial cost is only ignored. That's pretty good. I wish I could do that. Anyway, let's fight this person and see what there is to see. What did you free cast? All enemy creatures into play rested. That's okay. He free cast, so he didn't use any ether to do that. I mean, while that's really annoying and obnoxious, it's not like it's the end of the world. Let's hit him for one. He's a level 6, so should not be a problem, maybe. I say that, and then I failed at the rat test. Oh goodness, what are you doing now, friend? Oh, you're getting ether. Controller of this enchantment gains 5 life each time any creature uses regeneration ability. I don't think I should dispel that simply because I don't really have anything with dispel. I mean, with regeneration. And it's more important that I not lose my guys on the edge here, so let's make you. I'm gonna lose that bat though, but he's a, you know, I guess anything that gives him life, because he might be playing regeneration, anything that gives him life might be a problem. Oh, there we go. See, he had a plan. Regeneration 1. Regeneration 3. He is a 3-1. Let's just kill that. He would have gotten life there, see? So that was a pretty good idea, really. And we shall attack. It occurred to me, like, right after I got rid of the enchantment, that he might be, oh well, there goes my removal. He might actually be playing, yeah, there we go. He's playing a bunch of enchantments, actually. All creatures with flying ability, cannot get up ability. So these guys are now down for the count, I guess. I am very grateful that I have my enchantment removal. I didn't think yellow. I keep calling it yellow. I don't know why. I thought Well, I mean, it sort of stands to reason that red wouldn't actually give you anything like that. Let's just kill him. Bye. And bye. There we go. That wasn't very inefficient, really. But the thing is, they're free cards that I don't need to worry about because they're not in my deck. So, yeah, no. Buy removal. What have we got there? Okay. Your regeneration. 2. How many manas do you have? You have 1. Well, let's just get rid of that guy. That friendly friend. And do this. And again, because this is essentially free, I'll just use it to hit him for 1. Speed that clock up, man. Ta-da! See? No problem. That's what happens when your removal arrives on time. Ash Storm. All creatures cannot attack until end of turn. But, I mean, that's very weird. I don't understand why that's in the game. Because the only thing you can do at the end of the turn is attack. I mean, what? Maybe they ran into creative blocks and they're like, we don't know what to add.
I must first reconcile the East and the West.
What is this? You move your dwelling of weak creatures. Well, I mean, okay. I guess we'll keep going. Oh, hang on a second. I'm gonna get there by going around. Of course. And let's grab this, and then grab this. One of the other things that I find a little weird about this game is that while there are people, and while you can interact with them, they don't, like, patrol. So, for example, when you see, in this case, like this guy here, the Shaman's Bird, he's not moving around the village to check on his friends. He's just there. What's your plan, friend? Well, we'll just fight you. I'll look at it while I'm in the actual battle. Okay, so his plan is, the hero has a chance to draw one more spell from the spellbook each time he casts any spell. That's okay. I mean, it might be terrible because that's card advantage, but hopefully it won't be. I shouldn't really be putting down this many people. Zap is free. I was busy debating whether or not to put anger down or not. Okay, yeah, sure. What is it? It's all creatures with flying. Okay, well, I don't have any flying right now. But I will have soon. I'm trying to... This is 3. This is 2. And then I will be good because I will rescue this from falling off the edge. And I guess what we'll do for next turn is we'll turn your enchantment off. This is kind of what I had to do at the beginning of the rat fight. I just had to sit there and remove his enchantments all the time. Because that was, incidentally, what was killing me. It wasn't actually... Well, his 5-1 didn't help. Let's face facts here. But his the enchantments that he was running kept on being a problem. Oh, okay, you're gonna die. Yeah, let's use the free cards. And then save the actual hard removal for stuff that we know might be a problem. Attack! When I say hard removal, I really mean this. Okay. Alright, he still doesn't have two mana, so we're good, and I'm just going to get rid of that guy. This is my favorite way to play, incidentally. This is being a control deck. Oh, goodness. So now, I feel like he will actually have the mana to regenerate. Why did he do that? Oh, good grief. Okay, well, let's kill. Okay, that's not very effective. This is one. This is one, so that would be two. And then I'll remove his enchantment, so let's start by doing that. There. And there. This unfortunately makes. Oh! Are my bats flying? My bats are flying, that's good. I thought that would knock my bats out for the count for like, the foreseeable future. For that turn, at least. Oh well. Oh, yay, Ashstorm. Ashstorm is a thing that I'm going to trade away the minute I can trade it away. Because, like, lots of the other stuff is useful, and Ashstorm is not. The main building of chaos. Can I go in there? No. Is that? Wait a minute. Oh, it's the Castle of Chaos. I was gonna say, like, just looking at it, shouldn't it be called the Town Hall or something? That's the underpass he doesn't want to go into. Hello? Lamia monk. Oh, well. It's a pity you can't right click here either and see what's going on there. Hello, Lamia monk. How are you doing? That's not actually Lamia, I'm being terrible. That's Lamia. Any Lamia under the hero's control has a chance to remove one spell from the opponent's hand after having successfully hit that opponent. Which begs the question now, are they hasty guys? All enemy creatures in the play rested. Oh, sure. That's fine. I think I should turn that off. I am unfortunately going to lose access to some of my removal. Let's. You cost three. I need a guy. And I need to do this. So I don't lose more of my removal. Why are you not doing anything? This weirds me out a lot. How much do you cost? You have five. Again, don't really want to lose my good removal, so we will do this. I like how it's tempting you by turning Call Lightning on, and meanwhile the only person you can play it on is your guy. Oh, he's doing it again. Okay. Oh. Did he do it? He did it on the creature, of course he did. Because of the same race. I'm being dumb. Good grief. If the caster's opponent has a greater number of ether channels, the caster gains 3 ether channels, so he went up. Okay, I think we should play you and you so I don't lose you. I'll lose my removal. That's a pity. Meh. But at least I have enchantment removal now, which is important, I feel. Hey, it's our first Lamia. Lamia Warrior 7/7. He has a trample ability, and this is why I didn't want to lose my removal. But it's okay, because this is 6. And 7. Bye. That was super inefficient. Well, no. I mean, since it's granting me that, and the cost for one of them is 1. It's not that inefficient, but it's, in terms of card disadvantage, it's ridiculous, because I wasted 3 spells on a guy. Which is not a great idea. Make a little Lamia man. Oh. Same again. Alright. Unfortunately, this time, I am not going to have that sort of plan. So what I think I'm going to do, I'm going to hit there. Lamias can't block in the air, so let's fly through for a lot. I think I might actually kill him. I didn't do the maths. I really should do that when I attack. You won, but my favorite message. let's grab that. Anyway. I think we will go. Oh. I see a thing I want. 2 things I want. In this shrine, you can learn a new specialization. Oh, thrifty casting. That might be good, actually. Thrifty casting? There is a chance to cast a spell without expending its charge. You know, my important spell is this, and it has an X component. And it costs 1. So, I don't actually see a point in that. We've been talking about removing these for the longest time. I really should do that here. Let's put that there, and that there. See if we can find something better. Maybe, I don't want to do it, but we should maybe do, this annihilation. See, the thing is, this is yours and theirs. And it puts me in a worse position because it does damage. Maybe this is a plan? Let's try that. This gives me an ether channel, so it speeds up my big casts. I'm not going to pick thrifty casting because, like I said, most of the stuff that I have invested in is pretty cheap. Hello, Shadow Wolf. Wolfie, I didn't look at your special. Oh, I couldn't look at your specialization. Here is a chance to avoid or reduce damage received from the ether button. Oh, well, that's good. I'm glad you think I run that spell. Bye, friend. Can only be blocked by walls. Okay. That's a prob. Well, no, it's not actually. I lie. Because I've got a lot of removal. Okay. Oh, and it's a one ether guy? Oh. Let's do this. And make a bat. What are you doing? Oh, oh goodness. Power and toughness of the enchanted creature are reduced by 4. But toughness cannot become less than 1. If the spell has been discarded by an opponent's hero, the opponent discards 3 spells. So it's actually good that he played it on my guy. Because, I mean, not that I'm playing rats at this point in time. But if I was, I might have accidentally discarded it. And that might have been terrible. Are we doing it again, really? Do we not learn our lesson? So this is Geezer. You gain 1 ether channel. So if you look here, these are my ether channels. If I do this now, I will go up 1 instead of going up 1 whenever I have a turn. Or sometimes up 1 whenever I have a turn. Which allows me to cast more things. Basically, I'm trying to get to my giant bats. That's what I'm trying to do. First strike can block any of my walls. You cost 5 ether. Huh? Well, I guess we'll edit you out of the game. And... so the thing about casting Geezer is that it won't immediately give me mana. If you look at this, you'll see that I go down to 0 of 9. It doesn't immediately bump this by 1 and give you a bonus ether. It's just, you know, you get the ether channel and you spend the ether. It's not like magic wherein you put down a land and suddenly you have access to that land immediately. I guess I should feel sorry for him, but I kind of don't at the same time. And bats galore. Oh. I hit attack and then didn't see that because it's all dark and dreary. That he had actually moved forward. Oh. By what did you do there? Oh no, you're polymorphing. Destroy a target creature, the caster's life becomes equal to the sum of the power and the toughness of the destroyed creature. Target creature cannot use the generation ability to prevent this. The spell can be cast during block phase. I guess that helps him. I mean, it slows his demise down. I didn't know he was running removal. And the thing is that he's so low now that him actually gaining the life from Polymorph is helping him. Because it's combining the two, it's 7 plus 4. So he is actually going up. I feel like he's going to polymorph all the time now. No? Yes? Oh, good. No. Wow. That would have been frustrating. He might polymorph now, though. Yes, 2 cards in hand. I wonder what they are. Let's put you down. I don't think that he's going to make any more creatures, so the call lightnings are going to become a bit redundant. Oh well, it doesn't matter because he's dead. Oh. Aww. Why did I not level up? Well, because I'm miles away from a level up. And that will be us for today. Let's just have a look around the corner. Yeah, there's some freedom over here and over here. I think I'm going to end up fighting that guy. That's going to be a bit frightening because I'm level 9. Anyhow, thank you so much for watching. I've been your host, Lostwolfe. This has been episode 37 of my friend Etherlords 2. I hope you're enjoying it as much as I am enjoying playing it for you. I hope to see you soon. Have a wonderful evening, and good night for now, folks.